this is a pretty exciting video. I didn't think that I was gonna get this package today. I knew I was gonna get one of them today, but the other one said it wasn't gonna arrive till later this week. But I was surprised. I got some doll storage as well as a doll. And I'm also in this video going to be showing you some of the perler bead designs that I've been working on. Perler beads are pretty fun, and I'm also selling them if you want any of them. I have them on like Mercari or Depop too. They should be there. I got these acrylic display risers because I want more room for my dolls. I don't want them all just standing in front of each other. I can't really see them, so it says it has two sets of three. I guess you could use them for food too. Are you supposed to use acrylic around food? I also got these like clear, I believe they're acrylic, clear shelves to, might need a drill for them. I hope I don't need a drill for them because I don't think we have a drill. But either way, I think we have a screwdriver. I'll try to get some long nails, but I'm gonna put these in the walls, to also put my dolls on. I guess she's really the star of the show. I've been wanting her for a while, and I figured since I was already getting those shelves, and because Amazon has that thing where it's like $60 or $50 and then you get free shipping, I was like, might as well get a doll too. Moment of truth. Which one do you think it is? Do you think it's the green one? Okay. I hope she looks good. I've been really, really, really wanting her. This is Victoria Whitman. Wow. I really like the freckles on her. That was the biggest thing that drew me to her. I don't know if you can tell. I have freckles too. I wonder if you'll be able to see them. Freckles kind of are really easy to wash out, really easy to not show up. She already in box looks better than the other two dolls that I got off of Amazon that were also Rainbow High or Shadow High. I believe one of them was Shadow High. She's really, really pretty. I really like her earrings there and the little design of her in her box. She comes with a little sewing machine, a hair dryer, this little cell phone, a little phone case as well, and eyeshadow palette. And it's weird, she only has one outfit. However, she comes with a hanger or two hangers. She only has one outfit, so I'm not really sure why she comes with two hangers. I guess it's not a complaint though. It's always good to have more hangers and accessories for your dolls. I really like her on the back of the box. You can see her freckles pretty clearly. It's gold. And then the girl she comes with is pretty as well. She has some freckles with green nails. I'm not the biggest fan of the print. Something about camo. I'm not the biggest camo fan, but I love her green hair. I love her eyeshadow look, especially. Her eyeshadow looks more subtle, just a little, like, shadowy. Her knees are pretty red, but, I mean, being pale, I can attest to just your blood. You know, people can see your blood under your skin, basically. I was supposed to cook, and then my mom started cooking. So I'm gonna finish this video instead. I have my, all my supplies. Let me, I guess, since I showed you all that, before I get into unboxing everything, I'm gonna go ahead and show you a few of the just perler bead designs that I've made. They're really fun and they're really cheap. I think you can find perler beads like a lot of places. One thing about perler beads is they're pretty delicate, but I'll show you the first one I made. This was my first attempt at a perler bead design. I tried to make Mary, one of the Sanderson sisters. And then this is my second attempt. I realized I was gonna need a bigger board and I realized I was gonna need more bead colors. So this is my second attempt at Mary Sanderson. A lot better than this. I definitely found a skin color tone, which I'm glad I was worried they didn't make a skin color tone, but they do. So good. Oh my God. I thought a wasp was in here. I almost freaked out. And then I made Winifred Sanderson and Sarah Sanderson. So I made all three of the Sanderson sisters. And these are for sale if anybody wants them. I have them on Mercari. I've only made one, so I'll have to make them to order. So it'll take a little bit, but they don't take too long. Probably take me like an hour and a half maybe to do all three of these. Maybe, I'm not sure. I never timed it. But yeah, these are really cute, and it's all three of the Sanderson sisters. I love Hocus Pocus, and it's coming up. It's October. It's spooky month. It's about to be Halloween. And then these I did earlier today because I'm off today. I could sit down and relax and do something for myself. So this is the first one that I made today. I didn't follow a pre-made pattern for this one. I actually was just challenged myself to just look at a picture and put the beads together and just do it myself, and I did. I did a really good job. I think I would replace this one bead that's white with a pink. I missed that somehow, but it's the jellyfish meme of like the jellyfish shrugging from SpongeBob. SpongeBob is one of my favorite shows. So yeah, if you want a jellyfish, or I could sell him too. I really like the jellyfish. I love SpongeBob. And then I also made him. He was a pre-made design that I found on the internet. Ooh, maybe I could have warmed him a little more. He's a little creaky. But this is Scream, the little Scream dude. It's so cute. He has a little bloody knife. He's so freaking adorable. I love him a lot. He's so cute. My mom really likes him too. He's really cute. So yeah, bunch of perler bead designs. Well, I guess not a bunch, but these are the only ones that I've made so far. I really can't wait to make more. I think I'm gonna keep the first, like the prototypes of all that I make, and then make more to order. You can get like command hooks, put them on your wall. Yeah, you can turn them into keychains somehow. I don't have materials for that, so I can't, but you could. So yeah, I sell those. Also, I guess check me out on Instagram and Snapchat and all that. And also I have a Patreon, General Cadaver. So we'll carry on with the unboxing. What brand is this? It says Up Simples. Oh my goodness. They taped this shit up good. I'm glad there's not like too big of a glare in my glasses. It's later in the afternoon that I'm filming this. Usually try to film earlier in the day. Also, I will be getting a microphone soon, so don't give up on me. I'm gonna get a microphone. The sound will be better. I have to wait till I have the money. I'm trying to space things out, you know. One paycheck you get one thing, one paycheck, you know, just splice up what you need. Oh. All right. there. Very warm. This is them. Yeah, they look pretty spacious. Let's see if they can fit a rainbow high doll stand. Can I go get a doll or two? We'll test. Oh, I didn't think it came with nails. Look at that. It comes with nails as well. I don't believe I have a drill though. What are these white things? Whatever. Give me a second. All right, so this is Shadow High Demi Batista. Ooh, perfect. Wow, she fits perfectly. There's like even a tiny bit of space, a few millimeters. So that's wonderful. I didn't really think about that till after I bought it. I just assumed that it would fit for some reason, but I'm very glad that it does. Wow, that's great. I don't know how many dolls you could fit on here. Four to six dolls, depending. So that's good. It fits Rainbow High, so it should fit really any doll stand. All right, so those are gonna be good. Hopefully they aren't too hard to put in the wall. They come with a little user manual. I wonder if I need a stud finder. These shouldn't be too heavy. My mom said something about a stud finder. I don't know, what is that? What was that? I guess like a stud finder is to find like the posts in the walls, like the supporting beams. But I've never really hung up shelves. I don't think dolls will be that heavy though. I don't think I'll need to find a stud finder. I think if I just use a long enough screw and enough screws, because the wall is pretty good. I hang a lot of stuff up. Also, I'm sorry that the background is so dark. It's the evening. Goodness. So now I'm opening the risers. These say "and goo" acrylic display risers. Literally "and goo". Okay, it's packaged like that. That's pretty fun. Let's pull them out here. So I guess it was two packs of three, and the smaller sizes are like stacked on top of the bigger sizes. What is this? Oh, I guess this is like a little cleaning thing. Let me see what it says. "We are committed to holding to decorate your home with simple, functional, and trendy products. Assembly warranty, return and refund." Yeah. I guess the little rag is just to clean it. I guess, yeah. So it comes with a little rag and clean them. Go ahead and open them here. They don't look too thick. Or too, I guess wide, I mean. Hopefully they'll still fit the Shadow High doll. I mean, they should, obviously, if you balance them, but I don't want to run the risk, of course, of any dolls falling or anything. Okay, and they're all like wrapped and taped kind of individually. Just makes it a little bit difficult to get out. Oh, goodness. Okay, short one, and then the middle one. A lot of trash. Gee, that's hard. I'll take all that trash off eventually. So they're supposed to like sit in front of each other. I'll try to set them up somehow to show you. But see how they're longer? And then they gradually go up. So that'll be good for the dolls. And there's two bags. So let's see. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, so she fits. She doesn't fit as perfectly as she did in the other one, you see. There's a tad bit of overlapping on either side. But she still balances. I mean, I'm holding her with one hand. She's balancing. She's good. I think, you know, as long as you're still and have a stable surface, it'll be fine. So that's great. That's great. We don't have to send them back. Gizmo! I'm sorry if you can hear my cat meowing. I don't want her in here because they'll tear stuff up. These cats, man, I swear. And now for the main attraction of the video, I'm going to be unboxing Victoria Whitman. She's so pretty. I love her freckles. I love her little light blue eyes. Light blue eyes. The little illustration's really cute. I like that it's like gold for the outfit and hair, and then like black for just like the person outline. Her hair's like subtly pink. It's like blonde and pink, like a peachy color. I'm gonna try not to damage the box. I do like to keep the boxes. Oh look, it says Victoria, fashion design focus. I believe I have Rosie Redwood. I believe I kept her box, and her box says she is a cosmetology focus, which makes sense. She had makeup with her, as well as like a little drink. All right, I cut these. What now? I guess I really only need to open one side. Pour her out here. Get her. I'm trying. It's not coming out of the damn box. Okay. I got her out of the box. She's so pretty. I like the way her clothes feel. They feel about how I expected them to feel. She has like peachy eyelashes. Her eyelashes are kind of like the same color as her hair. A very peach color. Alright, I'm gonna start snipping away here. Trying to be very careful not to damage anything on her. She has very light pink painted nails. Oh, goodness. I'm always so scared unboxing the dolls. It's not, I don't really like unboxing the dolls. Well, I mean, I like having the dolls out of the box. It's just the process is a little difficult for me. I'm not very dexterous. Is that the correct word? Not very dexterous. I'm not sure if that's the right word, but oh, I forget about the backs of these, man. They're always so difficult. Her little legs are falling out of the box already. I think she's only being held on her head now. Should I cut this off? I do hate all the trash. They are really hard to get out of the box. Why do they put these in their heads? I hate these, like, little, I guess, I mean, I get that it's to keep them in the box, but I don't like that thing, because then it stays in their head and you can't get it out of the back of their head. I'm also sorry if you can hear my cat. Very annoying. Oh, I was trying not to mess up the inside of the box, but I ended up messing up the inside of the box. It's because these things suck. To open these dolls, it gives me nearly a nervous breakdown every time I do it because of the sheer amount of stress. Alright, Jesus, Lord, help. Where's my box cover? All right, let's see. Let's just come out now. Old Castle. All right, she's kind of coming out of the box. A little bit there. What is this stuck on? Alright. So she's out of the box. She's still stuck to this fucking thing. I hate these things. Keep cardboard boxes because I sell things and I ship things in them, and it's always good to recycle your cardboard boxes, so always keep them, always use them, because you never know when you might need a box. It's like plastic Walmart bags. So her hair is really gelled and stuck. I'm gonna have to take my silver comb and brush her hair out definitely. But she is really pretty. Their joints are really stiff. One thing about Rainbow High and Shadow High dolls, when I get them, I'm almost scared to move their joints because of how stiff they are. Her little shoes are really cute. They're like a peach. The straps are like a peach color and the bottoms are a pink color. I believe that says Rainbow High? Yeah, R8. Her little shoes, they don't fit on her feet perfectly. They're a little wobbly, but obviously she's on her stand and the pressure is on her stand and her feet, then they'll sit correctly. Ugh, I love her earrings. Her earrings are so pretty. Let me pull one out for you. All right, here, let me show you. This is her earring. It's really pretty. It's a little clear, kind of holographic flower with a little gold sun, gold flower, and then a little gold thing hanging down with little, I'm guessing like gems, you know, for the aesthetic. It is, I don't really know if you can see the holographic effect, but it is like a holographic effect on the clear petals. She's very pretty, gorgeous. I really like that she had freckles as someone who has freckles. Yeah, she's really pretty. I like her little outfit and the little tie. The little layers of the outfit. She has pink underwear, which is fitting for her color palette. I like the reddening on some parts of her skin, like her wrists and her knees. As a pale person, I mean, yeah, again, like you get really red all the time. She has freckles on her feet, her stomach. I think she has a little air bubble in her leg or something. I need to stop poking it. I don't know what that is. She has this little, see that little gray dot? It's kind of, I don't know, I need to stop messing with it so I don't ruin her. But yeah, she's really pretty. Yeah, I like her a lot. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you her accessories. So first, if I can get it out of my hair. These are the little hangers she comes with. They're, okay, these are actually easier a little bit than the first ones that I had to open and close, so that's good. That's just a little hanger, and then for like pants and whatever, this is the hanger for like shirts and stuff. It's coming off a little more pale pink on camera than it is in real life. It's a little more like warm pink in real life. She comes with this little hair jar. It has like the Rainbow High logo on it. Pink, white, and gold. Very fitting for the colors that she wears. She has this little makeup palette. The mirror on this one's definitely better. It's definitely a lot better quality than the other mirrors have been. See how this mirror is actually like really good. The other one that I have was not good. It was pretty warped, but this mirror sticker is very good. And the colors that it comes with are really pretty. I like the one in the middle. I like the little Versace Medusa ripoff thing. That's cute. I didn't know that the dolls were supposed to, like, that was one of their things that they did, was they came with, like, oh my, that's really cool. Okay, so look, this is her little sewing machine, and there's a lever on it, and watch the needle. When you twist the lever, that's super freaking cool. You can like drag fabric through there and she can pretend to actually sew the clothes and it actually makes the noise. That's really, really cool. That's awesome. I didn't know that about the toy. This is her little phone. She's a little iPhone. She's on Instagram, I believe. Yeah. She's on Instagram. This is her little phone case. I like the pink and the hearts and the sparkles. A little gold sparkles in there. And the phone fits in there pretty good. Just slip her phone right on in there. And it has a little thumb thing. So she can hold her phone. So yeah, she can have her phone in her hand with a little thumb swing. So that's great. She can be on the phone. Their joints are always so stiff. I don't know if it will actually reach her and look natural. That does really look natural. But, all right. I'm going to brush her hair out. I'm going to organize her stuff and then I'm going to show you her with her hair brushed and her on the stand probably tomorrow morning. All right. Hello. I wanted to get the rest of this video filmed before the sun goes away. So I think I left off. I needed to like brush. What's her name? Victoria Whitman. I needed to brush Victoria's hair. I'm gonna keep her box. I like the artwork on it and stuff and the colors and her other friend. It's a nice box. So here she is with her hair brushed. I brushed it last night. This is the next day. I probably could brush it more. I don't trust myself enough to boil wash it. I've never done that with a doll's hair before. I know a lot of people do that to make the hair look better. I just don't know about doing that. I've never done it before. I'm kind of nervous. Her stand is sparkly and pink. Very fitting. I do wish they came with two outfits, but apparently that's like not coming back with Rainbow High. I don't know what's going on. So I've just been buying the dolls. I guess I should have bought them back then. I didn't know that they were going to not be around anymore and I didn't have the money back then. I wish I did. I wish I would have had the money back then, but it's okay. There's some on Amazon. I hope the prices don't go up too much. But yeah, her hair's really pretty. I love the blonde and pink, like the peachy blonde. I think that's really, really pretty and it really fits with her outfit and her skin tone and the shoes as well. Again, it's two different pink colors. I like that. There's little gold accents on the shoes. She's very, very pretty. I love the little balls, little pearls on her outfit. The little embroidered stems and the flowers, they're 3D. 3D flowers there. A little necktie for the shirt. She's really pretty. I like the little braid in her hair. That's nice and fun. I really like her a lot. I have her little phone in her hand, her little phone in her phone holder. It just clips on, or phone case, I guess. It just clips onto her thumb. She's on Instagram. I don't know if you can really see. But yeah, she's on Instagram with her other friends. She's really, really gorgeous. All right, so I'm going to show you the setup that I have for my dolls now that I have the shelving. All right, so here are the risers. This is one of my new dolls, this LOL OMG surprise or whatever doll. These are the risers, and I also have two of the clear little acrylic risers put in on the top there. They weren't too difficult to put in. I could do it with a screw. The walls are fine here. So yeah, I need to get Jade. I have the other four. I need Jade in this line, and then I'll be probably moving Dana down, putting her on one right here. She doesn't stand up on her own, and she doesn't have a stand, so they're sitting down. I also have my other two dolls here. But yeah, they look really nice. I was able to set this up kind of last night and tonight. And I really like how they all look good together. I have her here. She doesn't really have any room on the Rainbow High thing, but I think they all look really nice. Okay. All right, that's the end of the video. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking around this long if you made it to the end. Let me know if there's any dolls in the Rainbow High line that you still need. Let me know what your favorite Rainbow High doll is, what your favorite Shadow High doll is. There's a bird out there. Thank you for watching. Check out my Patreon. Check out my Instagram. It's all General Cadaver. Hope you enjoyed the video, like I said. And yeah, please subscribe and stay tuned for more just random content. Doll content, me content. I don't know if you want any other content. I want to make a perfume video. I have a lot of perfumes. So if you want a perfume video, let me know. It's probably going to come regardless. But yeah, thank you for watching. The crops are bountiful.